Hey pharmacist, welcome back. Today we're diving into the world of Slynd, the latest progestin-only contraceptive pill that has some unique features. We're going to explore four of these features so that you can get to know Slynd a little bit better. So let's get started. Number one, Slynd is estrogen-free and contains the hormone drospirenone. Because there's no estrogen, Slynd is suitable for those that would normally use a progestin-only contraceptive, or mini pill, as they call them. So for those who have high BMI, smokers who are 35 or older, those who are breastfeeding, and overall those who need or want to avoid estrogen. Now, the fact that it's estrogen-free doesn't make it unique, but it's the first progestin-only pill that contains this hormone. Number two, mixed pill flexibility. Most traditional mini pills contain norethindrone. Comparing this to drospirenone in Slynd, drospirenone has a long elimination half-life of 30 hours versus norethindrone, which is only about a quarter at 7.7 hours. That means that Slynd stays in the body longer and can maintain therapeutic plasma levels to sustain a 24-hour missed pill window. Traditional mini pills have a 3-hour window, which is quite short and can be quite stressful for some people. So what does this mean for Slynd? So let's say, for example, your patient takes Slynd every day at 8 p.m. and on Monday they took their pill, but on Tuesday at 8 p.m. they forgot to take it. Well, they have 24 hours in order to catch up on that pill before their next pill, which would be Wednesday at 8 p.m. So that could result in them taking two pills on the same day, but then they haven't missed the pill. Now, if it's more than that time, so more than 48 hours since Monday at 8 p.m., then they've missed that pill and backup contraceptive will be necessary for them. Number three, dosing. Slynd comes in a pack with 28 tablets, 24 of which are white and contain the active ingredient, the progestin, and 4 of which are green and contain inactive tablets. Other mini pills, traditional progestin-only pills, come in packs of 28 and are taken continuously without stopping. The dosing of Slynd, however, has that familiar 24-4 dosing regimen, similar to combined oral contraceptives, some of them at least, that are aimed to offer a scheduled anticipated withdrawal bleeding. However, we've seen in clinical trials with Slynd that patients may not experience predictable or scheduled periods. So this is something to keep in mind. Number four, increased potassium. I encourage you to read the product monograph for all warnings and precautions to see who Slynd shouldn't be prescribed for and side effects to be aware of. One in particular to note is that the progestin drospirenone may increase potassium levels. Those with kidney disease, liver, or adrenal disease should avoid this product amongst others. If your patient takes medication on a regular basis that increases potassium levels, such as an ACE inhibitor, then it's important to check potassium levels in the blood before and during the start of Slynd. Also watch for drug interactions such as CYP3A4 inducers, as they can reduce the efficacy of this hormone. Here are my final thoughts. Slynd can be a great option for those looking to take an estrogen-free oral contraceptive and who are looking for more flexibility in case they miss their pill by a few hours. If your patient is open to non-pill estrogen-free options, then you may consider recommending a progesterone intrauterine system like Mirena or a progesterone implant, because as you know, birth control methods like oral contraceptives and patches are really good at preventing pregnancy if used perfectly. But we know that's not always the case, and these IUDs or implants tend to be the most foolproof options and thus more effective. So that's a quick look into Slynd. I encourage you to read more about it. I've included some links below. But if you found this helpful, please let me know. Like, subscribe, leave a comment, and I hope to see you next time. Bye, pharmacist.